race number one, determined by random draw. So Marco Andretti is on pole position with Ken Schrader, track co-owner and the local all-star, on the outside of the front row. While we see the rest of the starting grid, you want to dial up our pole sitter for this heat race?
Marco Andretti, this is Willie T. Come in.
I got you, bud.
You're ready for takeoff. They call you Jet Set Andretti, and you're starting next to Ken Schrader, the owner of the track. So I know you paid him a little bit to let you into turn one first.
Yeah, I'm not that worried about turn one. I think I'm just hoping to have them outright.
All right, so our format tonight, two 12-minute time heat races, invert the field from the finish of the first to start the second. The average finishing position of the two heats is where you line up for the main event. And look at this place. It's a third of a mile. It's got banks as steep as a lot of NASCAR super speedways. It's going to be just a lot of fun to watch. Pevely, Missouri, Ken Schrader in that 52 red, white, and blue machine. Marco Andretti in the orange car for the lead.
Schrader got an excellent start, but he knows this place. This is his party barn. All night long, even mid-pack runners, they're all sliding up and putting a slide job on each other. Absolute, you're going to see great racing. And on dirt, Alan, you want to stay on the moist part of the track because that's where the most grip is on dirt. As the race runs, as it continues, it's going to get dry. The dirt's going to dry up and the cars are going to slide even more and put more heat onto that right rear tire.
Here's a little three wide for third place. Tony Stewart, 14. Greg Biffle, 69. And Hailie, Deegan, 38. Looking at a little right rear damage on the Paul Tracy car. He and Ernie Francis Jr. got together toward the back of the pack while we were watching that three wide. And you see there's a little dangling particle there from the back of the Tracy machine. Flying at you. Wow.
You know, there's going to be quite a bit of that tonight. And, you know, Paul's true to form.
That bar came off in the middle of turn three, and drivers are dodging it, and the caution flag is out.
Schrader got another great start, but he's got his right side tires in the moist part of the dirt, which is where the grip is. So he got a good shot, a good slingshot coming off four.
Tony Stewart gets around Marco Andretti for second and sets off after Schrader. Now Andretti being pursued by Deegan and Biffle. That's Deegan in 38, Biffle in 69, while here comes Tony Stewart toward the front. This was off turn number four, about a lap, now two laps ago. That's Hailie Deegan trying to wheel it. Greg Biffle trying to find a way by, Matt.
The SRX crew did a great job with the switchover of making these SRX cars for in the dirt late model configuration. One of the things they added was the grill screen in the front to help keep the engines cool, to keep the mud off. The track a little heavy, so the screens are filling up a little bit. But Hailie Deegan now finally able to make it down to the inside. She loves running the middle of the track in one and two. Watch her line as she tries to work on that 98 of Marco.
And Deegan just tossing that car in the middle of the corner. This is for third place. Deegan inside. Marco Andretti trying to hang on outside. One squeezed in the wall. That you're talking about. Somebody slow on the front straightaway. That is Ryan Newman, who is off the pace after getting squeezed up into the outside wall, it looked like.
By Paul Tracy. So look at that right front fender right there on Tracy's car.
And Ryan Hunter-Reay has gone to the pit lane also, as the yellow flag has come out for a second time in our heat race number one. So got damage to the Newman car, to the Tracy car. Hunter-Reay's on pit road. That's pretty significant for Newman. What happened here?
Well, they both came off side by side, and believe me, it's hard to see.
Right.
Right? And there's no spotters. So Tracy was drifting up.
Checkered flag coming up here on the heat, but that car looks like it had a bad day at Flat Rock. She's pretty torn up on this three.
Flat Rock being a very small quarter-mile track in the southern part of Michigan. So that is the end of heat race number one. The clock expires under the yellow flag and with a whole pile of damage for the SRX pit crew to try and fix up for heat race number two.
This is the results from heat one. You see Ken Schrader, it's his place. He leads this, followed by Marco Andretti. And take a look at the fifth spot there. That is Hailie Deegan, who is rounding out the top five.
All right, Lindsay. So the good news is all of those damaged cars have been repaired by the SRX crew and are back on the speedway. Look at the lime green car, Paul Tracy, right? That's how he's going to line up.
I like that wing angle.
Yeah, side by side, by the way, with Ryan Newman, with whom he tangled earlier. Let's hear from Ryan.
I can't tell if it's a tire or suspension.
And Paul Tracy has come back down the pit lane for further attention to his car from the SRX crew. We hear on the radio his water temperature is too high. So Ryan Hunter-Reay with Matt Kenseth beside him, Tony Kanaan with Ryan Newman beside him, then Bobby Labonte and Michael Waltrip. Those are your first three rows, with Schrader and Stewart out in the back of the field as they come to the green flag for heat race number two.
Great start by Kenseth. Now, this is Ryan Hunter-Reay's first dirt race. Am I correct?
Ever
in his life.
Hunter-Reay in that black machine, number one car on the inside, fighting for the front. Ryan, an open-wheel pavement racer his whole life, walked into the track. The track's modified division was out doing some hot laps and time trials. Ryan was standing there looking. I walked up to him. This is a few hours ago. I said, "What do you think?" He said, "I'm on sensory overload. I've never seen anything like this." Now you're out there in the middle of it. Piece of debris has just come off of one of the cars and landed on the speedway. That is going to bring the caution out. It's about two-thirds of the way down the backstretch. It's the right front fender from Michael Waltrip's machine. Oh, did he catch the guardrail on the back fence? He did. Whoa. Wow. And that ripped the fender off his car. Paul Tracy is out of his car. We'll hear from him in a minute. First, Matt Kenseth chooses the outside lane. Ryan Hunter-Reay to his inside for the restart.
Place to do the restart.
Here's Tony Kanaan to the outside of Ryan Hunter-Reay for second as Ryan Newman tries the bottom. Second black car there is Ernie Francis Jr. back with us this week. So two of the black cars, one numbers one, Hunter-Reay, and 99 on board with Ernie Francis. On the racetrack, you've got Kenseth leading, Tony Kanaan second. Now Ernie Francis Jr. up to third, and Tony Stewart just rolled into fourth position and is moving toward the front. Marco Andretti has just knocked the nose off of his machine, trying to get it to pit road while they come around under green.
I know Stewart wasn't planning on that.
Of our superstar Saturday nights. Now Kanaan muscles his way to the inside of Kenseth for the race lead.
Well, they were just, discussing where they were going to have a beer after the race.
Here comes Tony Stewart down low. Kanaan hangs on for now.
I would like everyone that's watching this race, everyone in the audience, everyone on TV, to be able to go out and drive this. Just get in your rental car and drive around a dirt track like this. You have the most fun in your life.
As you work around here, as Stewart looks to the inside of Kanaan for the race lead.
See that slide job? That is a technique that dirt track legends know how to do. They'll start up high and then turn that, pitch that front end down low with the throttle and the steering wheel at the same time and drive down underneath and let it slide up and make the pass.
Farther back here, Ryan Newman, 39, dark blue machine. White machine is Bobby Labonte, 38. The dark red machine is Hailie Deegan, and then Ken Schrader in there. This group is running from 6th, 7th, 8th, and 9th. He's never won heat race number two. In heat race number one tonight, Stewart finished third. Heat race number two, he's going to come from way back on the starting grid to take the checkered flag as these fans all come to their feet and give a cheer for one of their heroes. Tony Stewart wins heat race number two tonight in Pevely.
2. Here are your results. Most impressive, Tony Stewart working his way from the back of the field to come back and win Heat 2, followed by an aggressive performance by Tony Kanaan. We've got much more to come. It's time to get this action started. So let's send it upstairs. Alan Bestwick and Willie T. Ribs. Alan.
All right, Lindsay. 2 laps before we get the green flag on this main event. So average finish of the 2 heat races puts Tony Stewart and Ernie Francis Jr. on the front row. And all of the beaten and battered cars from the first 2 heat races are repaired and on the track for the start of our main event. Tony Stewart and Ernie Francis Jr. lead the field to the green flag.
Tony Stewart, as expected. Ernie slots in right behind him, but he's not going to settle for a run in second. I mean, this is the return of the Ernie and Tony.
So Stewart, Francis Jr., Deegan, Schrader, and then Tony Kanaan running in 5th position. Marco Andretti in 6th, Bob Labonte in 7th, Greg Biffle 8th, Ryan Newman 9th, and then Paul Tracy in 10th spot. So Stewart opening up a little bit of a gap now on Francis Jr. Back in the field, Ryan Newman just picked up a spot a few laps ago on Bobby Labonte. And the closest race for position would be now Tony Kanaan hanging on behind Ken Schrader. Here's the visor cam again from Hailie Deegan as she pursues Ernie Francis Jr. SRX green flag lap limit in this main event. Or as I prefer, the fun flag. Ryan Hunter-Reay did make a visit to the pit lane under this yellow. He's back on the racetrack. It's Stewart choosing the outside lane, leading the field back to the green flag with Francis Jr. to his inside. Trying to get the run on Francis Jr. for 2nd. Slips up the racetrack. Here comes Schrader down low. Caution flag is out. Paul Tracy has had some trouble. He has found the inside wall down the back straightaway. And Matt Kenseth's car comes to the pit lane, missing a lot of rear bodywork. Got collected when Tracy's car spun. That collapsed wing and the damage from earlier may be contributing. You never know.
Remember Howard Cosell? Down goes Frazier.
Yes, he's had his share of getting knocked around tonight. Here's another run. Look at it from his camera. Wrong place, wrong time.
There's no water in it because we pushed all the water out.
Well, we need to know when you push the water out. We would have put water in you like we did everybody else.
So the conversation back and forth, and not looking good for Hailie Deegan right now. Under the yellow flag here in Pevely, Missouri, Tony Stewart is our race leader. Still running a couple extra laps under caution here. You see Hailie Deegan's car still being surrounded by a swarm of mechanics. And they're hoping to get her back in the race, but at some point may not be possible. We'll just wait and see. They're trying to put the hood back on the car now. And we're getting down to the business end of this main event here on Superstar Saturday night. Ken Schrader is in the outside lane behind Stewart. Marco Andretti slides up to the inside of row number 2. Here we go. Green flag is out. Bobby Labonte is in 5th position. We got a caution out. Tony Kanaan has spun in turn number two and is trying to get refired. And so that is going to reset us for 10 laps to go. Watch Kanaan, pink car.
Around he goes. Just like Paul Tracy did earlier.
Oh, man.
Paul's just helping him to get straightened out.
Okay. I'll bet the view from PT's camera is a good one. Stewart is the control car on the outside. Andretti trying to stay with him on the inside in the orange car. Francis Jr. looking to stay right there, too. And the green flag is out. 10 laps to go. Schrader with a run to the outside of Marco Andretti for second as Stewart tries to get away.
Great start by Stewart.
And the crossover.
The slide job on Marco just now by Schrader.
These fans all on their feet cheering for Ken Schrader, but here comes Andretti back to his inside. Andretti back to second. By the way, Michael Waltrip in that blue car, all around goes Ernie Francis Jr. off of turn number two. Caution is out. There, and we've still got 6 laps to go. You think Ernie just ran out of tires, huh?
No, well, the track, the more they run on it, the drier it gets. The drier it gets, the slicker it gets. That's why Stewart has been so great at keeping the car up on that high line, because the higher you're up, it's damp up there.
All right, coming to the green flag. Stewart and Andretti, Schrader and Waltrip, then Newman and Labonte in row 3, 8 laps to go. Oh, Schrader had to jump out of the gas as Marco Andretti slid up in front of him. That's Michael Waltrip on the bottom in blue as Bobby Labonte goes around in turn 4.
Came out of nowhere.
Caution flag again for Labonte's car sitting up in turn 4. He gets it fired up. And we'll get another side-by-side restart. Did he get help? Oh, maybe so. Yep. Ryan Hunter-Reay in that one car with Tony Kanaan. Maybe about half the field to his inside, too.
Well, and Hunter-Reay got sort of moved out, and he got moved out right into... Kanaan moved him out into Labonte.
Yeah, look at that. I could generously call that 6 wide. There's another one. Andretti rides through the middle. Stewart holds on to the lead. Schrader will clear Michael Waltrip, drop to the inside, and see if he can make some ground up there. Ryan Newman gets a huge run off the top side of turn 4 in that 39 car. Look at Newman charge. Stewart Newman tries the big dive and slide in turn 4 again to see if he can get third from Ken Schrader. It's Stewart, Andretti, and then this for third place. Start Stewart, Andretti, Schrader, Newman, and 3 laps to go. Everybody's trying them.
Yeah, in the center.
Oh, got a car around. Hunter-Reay spun, collected by Bobby Labonte off of turn four. Yellow flag again. Kanaan, Hunter-Reay, Labonte. Outside in red, Andretti inside in orange, with Schrader, red, white, and blue outside, and Newman, beaten and battered and bandaged, inside of row two. Green flag. Stewart gets away. Newman tries the big run into turn number three to slide up in front of Schrader. He'll squeeze his way. Here comes Biffle down low in the gold car. As the white flag is out, we're on the last lap of our main event. Stewart with a couple of car lengths over Andretti as they hit the backstretch. Final two corners. Fans here all on their feet. Stewart slides wide. Schrader tries to run down low, but the checkered flag and an SRX win at Pevely goes to Tony Stewart.
Awesome.
I mean, despite the cautions, it was hand-to-hand combat.
Pevely, Missouri. We've got a winner in Tony Stewart. The fans called it. That's what they expected. That's what happened. Marco Andretti, the third week in a row, he's finished second. And Ryan Newman coming in third. Matt Yocum standing by with Tony Stewart. Yocum.